17 of 27. Battle for second place between Daniel Manikov and Jairo Villa. Jimmy Fluke is in fourth position. Second and third, Daniel and Jairo. Diego Comuni is fourth. Luca Gretti in fifth place. He dropped back after a spin. Sixth is Dave Watts. He started in the middle of the pack, so good race for him. Let's go back to Jairo, who is attacking Daniel. Jairo is now in second place. Going through the standings, position 6 for Dave Watts. Evan Merrill now in 7th place. He had off track as well, not on camera. Matthias Weiger came up to 8th place after dropping back. 9th position for Claudio Ferrari. Giovanni Sellito is 10th. Dujon Boldrin 11th. Jose Nunez 12th. Jason Perry 13th. These three drivers were battling really hard a couple of laps ago. Ed Rice in 14th place. He just passed Tim Weiss, now 15th. Pierre-Antoine Coupol, sorry for the pronunciation, is 16. Luca Varani, position 17 after the accident and pit stop for repairs. Mario Pires, 18th. 19th place for Fulvio Policardi. Manning Greenan is in 20th place. Sergio Sabatini, 24th, everybody else retired. Let's go back to the battle for second and third with Jairo Villa, Daniel Manikov and Diego Muni just behind them. Battle for 12 is also interesting. Jason Perry still trying to get past Jose Nunez. Dujon Boldrin just ahead of them seem to have built a little gap. Bold move by Jason, very nicely controlled. T1 is a very difficult track, very difficult corner. Gearbox of Jose Nunez. Jason Perry getting close to him. Off track for Jose. Jason can get through, he's now 12. Let's have a look at our leader, Jamie Fluke. Very impressive performance. Let's see how he's driving. He has a 4.7 second lead over Jairo. Second place. this is lap 20 of 27. Jamie seems to have a comfortable lead. In front is Manning Greenham, he's lapped currently in 20th place. Big slide by Jamie. Let's see a replay from its cockpit. The cars have spread out a little bit, except that Gianni Salito just lost a position, not sure why. Let's get a replay. Went off track by himself. Gianni currently in 11th place. He's gonna be passed by Duljon with a white and red car. Gianni's now 12th. Car battle for 10th place. Team Rice and Ed Rice, with 5 laps to go. They're battling it out for 14th place. We have been close for quite a few laps now. Now let's go back for position 2. Daniel is now only 3/10 of a second behind Jairo. It should be 5 laps to go. Our scoring system is a little off, unfortunately, but it should be 5 to go. Another big slide by Daniel this time. The race has been going on for about 40 minutes. The tires are worn. They certainly do not have as much grip as in the early stage. Meanwhile, Matthias Weiger just passed Evan Merrill for 7th place. Evan was very slow. Must have had an off track. Sorry, we didn't catch it on camera. back to the battle for 10th. Battle for second, Daniel is getting closer to Jairo, but he cannot quite pass him. Lap 23 of 27 now. On my scoring system that Dujon, Giovanni and Jason are very close to each other. The battle for 10th place. Frankly, I'm not sure what to follow. Jason is very close to Gianni. A little wide of the chicane. Jason cannot quite find a way through, but now he has a run of it. Going up towards Druids. Jason is on the outside. Well done, Jason. Nice pass. The orange and black car is Claudio Ferrari. Very slow, must have had a off track. Let's see if we can catch it. Claudio Ferrari, he was in position 9. Wide, through it. It's a difficult corner. Gets back on track without contact, but he cannot avoid being passed by 3 cars now. Claudio Ferrari now in position 12, attacking Gianni. Giovanni Sellito. Ooh, that's a touch, not nice. Salito wide again in T1. Claudio is now through. Position 11 for him. Jose Nunez in the purple car is hitting actually Claudio from behind. Too bad. Let's see a replay. Was a messy situation. Giovanni Sellito had gone wide, so it was a little slow off the line. Jose Nunez had a good run of them on the purple car on the right. It seems just to have missed his breaking point and rear-ended Claudio. Too bad. Meanwhile, Pierre Antoine just arrived long at the hairpin by himself, conceding position 16, now 15 to Luca Varani. Daniel still very close to Jairo. Battle for second place. Jamie Fluke is 5.67 seconds ahead. not in contention. He has the win. Lap 25 of 27. Meanwhile, Daniel may have a run on the inside. No. Tighter line, yet sacrifice exit speed. Let's follow these two guys for the end of the race. Whereas Matthias Weiger is now just behind Evan Merrill. Let's switch to them. They've been switching position over and over. Battle for 7th place. Both cars have damage. These guys must have had some accident. It's the last 2 laps for Jamie up front. We're watching battle for 7th place between Evan and Matthias. Matthias was the winner of race 1 in Okayama. Evan was up to 3rd place, I remember, I think, maybe 5th place in the early laps. He dropped back a little. Evan defending the inside. Daniel is still 0.2 seconds behind Jairo. These two guys don't seem to be able to pass each other. Whereas Matthias is having a good run on Evan. Much better exit speed. On the outside, on this corner, very, very bold move. Well done to both of them for holding up to it. Matthias is on the inside now. Lap 26 of 27, meanwhile. Matthias is up to 7th. I thought there was still 1 lap to go. That's what my scoring system was telling me. It's the last lap instead. Team Weiss and Luca Varani, position 14th. A few corners to go for them. Team is getting inside, but he's low. Must have missed a gear or something. Luca Varani is through for position 14. Final standings will be shown in a moment. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed the broadcast. Fulvio Policardi, damage car for him as well. He's in position 18th. He's finishing his race. Behind him, position 19th, per Manning Greenan, 20, Sergio Sabatini. Daddy Ferrari retired after the accident we've seen earlier. He's 21st. 27 drivers started the race. 6 of them did not conclude it. Thank you again. Hope to see you next time for race 3 of the iGPFun SRF 2015 Season 1 Challenge.